स्टूडेंट्स, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर सेल टुडे। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोना टॉक अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन, द डिस्कवरी ऑफ सेल, नंबर ऑफ सेल्स, शेप एंड साइज ऑफ अ सेल्स एंड द पार्ट्स ऑफ अ सेल्स लाइक सेल मेम्ब्रेन, साइटोप्लाज्म, न्यूक्लियस एंड फाइनली द प्लांट सेल वर्सेस एनिमल सेल। सो व्हाट इज सेल? हैव यू एवर हर्ड द वर्ड सेल? Have you ever heard the word cell, or you have used it when you talk to somebody? So cell is one cell is your cell phone. I'm sure. So that is something which I'm sure you all are aware of. And what is the other cell? The word cell, it means a room, you can say, or a small block. For example, you may have heard the cells inside a prism. The entire prism is divided into a small blocks, and each block is occupied by a prisoner. So each block is a cell. So cell is like a compartment. It is like a compartment. So when it comes to a living organism, what is a cell? Cell is the building block of all living organism. Now, what do you mean by building block of a living organism? Now, take an example, like any building you have seen, do you think that, how is the building get constructed? How is the building being constructed or made of? Do you think that one fine day you have decided that, okay, I'm gonna construct a house and that house should have two rooms, should have one bathroom, should have one kitchen and etc. etc. So what happens? You just think it and the next day you get the house. Not really. You first make a design of the house and then you are going to start that construct the house with the help of bricks. So each brick, they are like a blocks, and all the blocks together construct the entire building. So we can say that bricks are the building blocks of this house or a building. So in very similar way, in our living organism, if it is a dolphin, it is a fish, an elephant, a bird, a tree, all these are the living organism. All of these are living organisms, so they are also made up of something, and that basic unit or that something is nothing but a cell. Now you can clearly imagine cell as a brick. Cell are the brick, that is multiple cell together form a body of a human being. How it is look like? How exactly it forms so many it do so many different activity in our body? The cell is actually a. So we are going to talk about all that. Cell is exactly. It is a very vast subject. There are many details about this. But right now we just talk about some basic things, because further detail we will talk about in higher classes. Okay. So let us define what is a cell. Cell is the structural and functional unit of life. So cell is a structural and functional unit of life. When I say structural and functional unit, so what do you mean by structural and functional? When I say structural unit, that means the structure of the living organism is being basically made up of cell. When I say functional unit, I mean that all the function that is being done, for example, in human being, inside of our body, so many activities are going on. Digestion, excretion take place. So respiration takes place, circulation takes place. So many processes inside our human body take place. So how do you do these activities are being performed? So there are also the basic unit is cell. So cell is actually perform all this structure and as well as functional unit of our life. So that is why entire body perform those functions. So cell are structural as well as functional unit of every living organism. So, well, it is not always necessary. There has to be a multiple cell. Gradually, we will talk about the number of cell. That means it is not necessary that in all the organisms there will be a multiple cell. We're gonna talk about some organism which is made up of only one cell also. So now we'll discuss discovery of cell. So what happened was, there was a scientist named Robert Hooke. Robert Hooke, around 1665, discovered. He was the first one to discover cell. So here is also a very interesting story. So somewhere around 1661, King Charles of England, he asked Sir Christopher Wren to make a series of microscopical studies. So he wanted Sir Christopher Wren to make a note of, to make a detail of microscopic, that is using a microscope. He want to see the microorganism. He want to make a detail whatever he had seen through microscope. But unfortunately, what was happened, that we can say fortunately or unfortunately, that Sir Christopher Wren he was quite busy and he did not have time. So he handed it to a different scientist, that is a Robert Hooke. So, and Robert Hooke was 26 year old, and it means he was quite young. And he was very interested in doing this. I mean, all he was supposed to see the, he want to just see all the objects through microscope. Okay, so that is a job he is assigned to. And he put his lot to find out, and that's how he designed a self-design of a microscope. And with the help of that self-design microscope, and with where he tried to improve the efficiency of microscope. So how do we say that microscope is more efficient, which he designed? Because it has a better magnification, it gives us a detailed thing of even of a small object. Okay, so it is more efficient as compared to that of an old microscope. And he improved the efficiency of that microscope. And out of these, the interesting thing which he had made is, he observed a large number of objects. So what he did was, once he observed the cork. The cork is nothing but the bark of a living tree, bark of once a living tree, which is living at once. So bark is, so we use the cork in a bottle. So this is how it cork look like to fit in a bottle. Okay. Then he observed, on viewing thin cutting of cork, he discovered that there are empty spaces containing by walls. So he took a very thin slice of this cork, and when these slices observed under the microscope, then he observed that it was like a honeycomb structure, okay, which was surrounded by walls. Now cork was basically a dead tissue. It is a bark of a tree which was once living, okay. So what he was observed, what actually the tissue of a plant, dead plant tissue. So on viewing the cutting of cork, he discovered empty spaces contained by walls, and they resembled like honeycomb structure. So actually it was nothing but a empty spaces. It's like a honeycomb. Okay. So, since the cork is a dead tissue, so the cells are also dead. So, he not only experimented this thing, but when he saw this, he want to understand what was this, and for that, he just He experimented many other living cells also. He started observing living cell, and then he concluded that every living organism is made up of such compartments. They were filled with some juice like structure. So all living organism made up of some living compartment which are surrounded by something wall. Okay. So this was his observation at the end of all his microscopical studies. Now what did he call these compartments? So what did he call these compartments? These small spaces or these small compartments are like a small spaces or compartment. So many multiple blocks together form a entire living organism. So he named these small compartment as a cell, because the word cell, it was a Latin word. The cell is actually a Latin word and it means small rooms. Okay. Now, because of structural or of the cells, he named them nated cell, and that is how the cell was coined. Okay, which we can see with the help of microscope only. We cannot see the cell with the naked eyes. And that's how the Robert Hooke also concluded that all living organism is made up of a small compartment, and these compartment is called cells. And if he wanted to look the what a cell is made up of, he need even more powerful microscope. But he did not. But the later on, the internal part of the cell will gradually discovered, and the scientists will found the few the details of the cell. And today we know the entire structure of the cell. So this is how cell was discovered, and these faces which was observed by Robert Hooke are termed as cell. This was quite interesting because the microscopical study is assigned to somebody else, and he's another guy, Robert Hooke, who discovered the cell. So now once cell was discovered, many scientists discovered many other details of cell, various parts of the cell, various function of the cells with time. So there came a cell theory, a complete cell theory, which consists of, in terms of the discoveries, like around 1665, Robert Hooke discovered the cell. Okay, again after this Robert Brown in 1833 discovered the nucleus in a cell. Okay, so nucleus is again which very important name which is present inside a cell. It is accommodate inside a cell and it play a very important role. We will talk about nucleus as we go ahead. It was discovered in 1883 after the cell was discovered by Robert Brown. And later, a couple of scientists like Sladen and Swan proposed cell theory around 1839. So this cell theory described the quite few points of the regarding the cell, regarding the problems of the cell. So these are coupled together in a cell theory. Okay. Again, after a couple of years, in 1885, there was a scientist called Virchow. He gave some modification about the existence of cell theory. So, cells arises from pre-existing cell. That is, new cells that are originate from the existing cell. So, these are some of the evolution, something about cell theory. So what exactly a cell theory is? Cell are structural and functional unit of life. This is because as per microscopic test, it is found that the entire body of an organism is made up of a small compartment called cells, and obviously it is a structural unit. And also later it was found that the function which are performed in the living organism body, the base of those function is actually a cell. So the cell was a functional as well as a structural unit of life. So that was the first thing which was proposed by cell theory. The second was, all organisms are made up of cells. All living organisms are made up of cells. The living organisms which are made up of cells, we are not defined them as a living organism. So human body is also made up of many cells. Okay, so that's why the human being are said multicellular organism. Now, without exception, all living organisms are made up of cell. Any organism which is not made up of cell will not be defined as a living organism. And that is why in one of our previous lesson when we are talking about microbes, so the microorganisms are not made up of cell. That is why viruses are termed as acellular. Other than that, if you talk about any other living organism, they are all are made up of cells. All cells are derived from pre-existing cells. Cell cannot come out of their own. So whatever the cell existed, so the new cell are formed from the existing cell. So these three are the points which are given by the cell theory.